go.
This is it, man. This is so for real right now.
Sure is. Feels real.
Yeah, I feel like my heart is pounding.
And we seem to be clear.
Oh my gosh, we're hitting the open road and our bus home. Can you believe it?
This is crazy. This is it, day number one.
We just got one more new tire on the back this time, and we're continuing on our mission.
Oh, there's that smell again.
Sewage smell, there it is again.
We gotta figure out where that's happening.
Yeah, it's so weird. How? I smelled the sink drain, I smelled the shower drain. Couldn't be the washing machine, could it? They all have a HEPA valve though.
Yeah, they do.
Unless those HEPA valves just aren't as good as we thought they were going to be, and it's just leaking up through that.
Well, yeah, it shouldn't.
I know, it doesn't make sense,
but
does
it? We haven't found where it's coming from.
Well, baby, this is your first time on the interstate in the bus.
So true. Hey, is there a dump station around here? Okay, all right, thanks. Gas.
You've got gas.
I've got gas.
The bus has got fuel. The
bus is all fueled.
That's right. You guys, it has been such a busy day of running errands and round and round, all the tying up all the loose ends we had to tie up.
I'm heading.
To be able to head out to our camp spot for the night. So it's after 5 o'clock and we're barely finally on our way. Not even scared to be driving us on this road right now.
You're wrong about that.
You are scared?
It's not scared, just concerned.
Clenching a little?
Yeah.
Are we?
A little bit of pucker factor going on for sure. Oh, how about this right here? Oh, yeah. Now that's what I'm talking about.
Just kind of out in the middle of nowhere?
This is perfect. This is it. This will be just fine. Look at the view we have. Like, this is great.
Let's get as level as we can get then.
Well, the good news is the whole smell issue's gone. The overheating issue went away a long time ago. And I don't know if level is like,
I don't know, but something
just... Oh my God, I have a car back there.
I'm crunching
her. car
onto something. Unless that was just wood crunching. Oh, yeah.
No, that was our car.
Yeah, sure was.
Steam's not going right.
Well, it's been a lot in one day.
Well, we don't hook the car.
Okay.
Full transparency, because we always tell you guys, we don't hide anything. And so when we got here, major blunder. We pulled in, and then we were like, hey, we need to get a little more level. So I backed up, and I got a tow vehicle in the back, and I...
And backed up turning.
It backed up and crunched, and I crunched the front end of our Jeep, and I'm just...
Yeah!
Ouch. So it tempered my excitement of being out here, but my nerves are frazzled from getting out here, because the bus was running hot all the way here. I don't think it likes towing. So we may not be able to get away with towing it. We might have to drive separately. Don't know. We'll see. But as of right now, we're in place and it's pretty cool. And you'll see in the morning, it's a beautiful place. We love coming out here. We've camped here 1,000 times and over the years. And it's just, it's so beautiful here. And so.
Most of all, we're just happy to be here right now.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll catch you in the morning and we'll show you where we're at.
It's cool. We're here though. First night, like for real, we're here.
So it's first thing in the morning on our first day, and guess what Mike's doing? Putting the coconut core in the composting toilet.
That's right.
For the first time, we finally remembered we needed to do that. There it is.
There's no poo in there yet.
Fresh, clean cocoa core.
Give it time. We had to put like a quart and a half of water.
On the coconut brick.
Yeah, on the coconut brick, and it had to sit for 3 hours, which we just let it sit overnight. And then this morning I just crumbled it up and put it in here and then managed to pour it all over the floor and stuff.
And I'm sorry I didn't show you. I didn't know he was doing it, so I didn't have a chance to grab the camera and show what was going on.
That's my MO.
That's how he rolls.
Just get it
No
done.
Communication.
None.
This is a pretty awesome view to wake up to in the morning.
It really is.
It's a great coffee view.
Coffee. This segment is brought to you by... Subscribe right now.
Subscribe to see more of our new boon vlogging series.
That's right. We're boon vlogging. That's a good one. I like that.
I love it. Let's look in this window too. Mama Sita, did you come back inside?
She's already used to going outside and inside. We had a little problem last night.
Yeah, she got out last night and didn't want to come back in because she was probably traumatized by our day of errands yesterday, by how many times this bus got turned off and turned on and we drove all over the place. No, I don't want her on the table.
I would have let her on the table because I'm a good owner. She's
Everybody wants to see Mama Sita, so we can at least get her up here.
I do, Mama.
Okay, Dad wins.
Yeah, she got out, and I chased her for probably, I don't know, 30 minutes. And finally, I got her to come up to me, and I snatched her up and brought her inside. But I was like, I didn't want to leave her out overnight because out here there is wild animals. Yeah. Out here we've got mountain lion. There's bear, actually. There's leopards, surprisingly enough, though they're quite rare. Coyotes, skunks, raccoons, cotamundi. Anyway.
Did you say bobcat?
Oh yeah, there's bobcat too. We have to kind of keep her inside at night. If she wants to go out and go to the bathroom or something, we have to kind of go out with her.
Yeah.
But
she has a litter box in the bus too. She just hasn't used it yet. She prefers to go outside. She has her ways, you know. Mm-hmm. It's another bus life first this morning. Mike's making fudge in the fudge factory.
Yep, I'm doing my duty.
Literally. How's the poop aiming going?
I'm afraid like if I missed or something, but then I had to pee and I had to close the chute. And I'm thinking, what if I just like guillotine to be turned? So bad.
Things you never thought you would say.
I'm afraid to look. What if I missed and it just...
Oh God, it's too Oh, it's too horrible to consider. Don't even think about it. So we changed locations probably like less than a mile down the road because we found this magnificent tree. I can't even get the full tree in the camera. There's some trucks with horse trailers parked here right now, but they're just here for day rides. They're not camping, so we'll have this place to ourselves by this evening. That should be cool.
Take care.
Bye. Bye-bye. Thank you.
And now we have this whole place entirely to ourselves. This is super fun. I'm loving it here already.
This is a great spot.
It is. This tree is magnificent. Okay, I have to go let you guys like get the image of what this tree is really like. See? The tree is magnificent. What a great place to park and camp, right? I'm loving this. It is a really good spot. I can't even describe to you how good it feels to be sitting here in the shade of this big tree, doing absolutely nothing. Nothing. After the past 3 years of building this bus, and especially after the past month of moving out of our house and into the bus, it has been such a huge effort and so crazy and chaotic. This is just heaven to be sitting here doing nothing. We are taking you to a place that's so cool. It's called Council Rocks because ages ago, this is where the Indian chiefs would come meet and have their council. Come on, baby.
I'm coming.
This is my favorite part of the trail, where the little stair steps are dug out. Isn't that so cool?
It is.
Am I taking this the right way?
Yeah, if we go around the left up here.
Okay, come check this out. So it seems like you would have been able to paint these by standing on the ground right here. But how do you suppose they painted that? Someone probably had to get on someone else's shoulders or something.
Maybe he was just ridiculously tall.
And what is the deal with the person with four arms? Like, what is the story behind that?
Aliens.
It didn't explain that on the plaque.
Aliens, of course. Why does he have feet like lizards?
Yeah, he has lizard feet.
Aliens.
That's probably true. They were probably communicating with the aliens even before us, huh?
Yeah, obviously.
Clearly. Oh yeah, there's another one way up there.
Yeah, right there. Over here, these are metates. This is where they used to grind like flour out of the mesquite
grains and mesquite beans and stuff.
Yeah.
These are nice deep ones too.
Yeah, you can tell that those are just man-made. They can't be otherwise.
Okay, I don't know if you guys can get the scope of how massive these boulders are and the way they're all kind of leaned up onto each other forms all these little crevices and
caves.
Kind of caves that you can go between. And in here, in this crevice, I think is the council rock through here. There's a flat rock propped up over here. Oh, you came that way?
I'm not bending down like that. You could totally like sleep in here. You'd be sheltered.
Yeah.
Nice little cave.
It's the coolest place, you guys. I don't know how you can tell from the camera, but it's really neat to be here.
And cool.
Yeah, it's nice and cool in these shady, under these shady rocks.
Oh, these are, oh, I like them, that's for sure.
To the left?
To the
or to the right.
By C-130.
That goes back out to the main entrance. Oh, boulder in our path. Dead end. There's more metates all over the place. I think when I used to bring my kids up here, they would run around and try to count them all. But I don't remember what number we ever came up with. It's just cool that they're all over the place here, and you know they're from ancient times when the American Indians were living here. Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful thing. Okay, so if any of you would like to read about Council Rocks, Land of Legends, go ahead and pause right now.
Well, we should probably head back and check on Mama Kitty.
Yep, I think you're right.
She's still getting used to it, but phenomenally, she's just likes, I think she likes this. A little weird, she hates the movement. But.
Well, she likes the bus as long as the bus is not moving, and that's good that she loves the bus and she wants to go to the bus and that she considers that her home.
Yeah.
So that's a good thing.
Check this out.
We put the margarita mix in the freezer. And it is half frozen, like to slushy consistency. Oh no, can you get the spout out?
You know I can't get the spout out.
I forgot
out.
There was that. Good one.
Got it.
Oh my gosh. How awesome is that? I had no idea you could make a margarita just by putting that stuff in the freezer.
I know, that's pretty cool.
Very cool.
Forgot to salt. I'll just have to get through it.
Wow, how's that, Margie?
First 20 in the bus. It's delicious. Very good.
The margarita glass is like kind of lighted up. It looks so cool.
Oh.
Well, we just had a whole conversation without you guys because the record button wasn't on.
You would think you had the margarita.
Fail. Right? He's the one that's drunk over there.
I'm not drunk. I got to give props to Jose Cuervo on that premix. I'm glad. Okay. I know how to make a good margarita. I was a bartender, okay? But, like, we have to make sacrifices.
A limited space.
Living in a bus. So we got the all-in-one premix with alcohol margarita mix. And yep. I'm giving props to Jose Cuervo for not skimping on the tequila on this one.
We moved the bus again because the magnificent tree was casting way too much shadow on the solar panels on the back of our bus right here. So we just moved to just across the little way over there. And the sun is setting on an outstanding day.
It's so good.
It is. It has been so awesome just to be out here all day. We really got to unwind. Mama Kitty, somebody's feeling adventurous. All right. She finally came out of the bus on her own, went potty, and now she's climbing the tree.
Maybe she was just all stuffed up.
Meanwhile, we have an awesome fire going on over here. Just Mahoney and me.
It's like we're on a permanent camping trip and it's not bad.
It's not bad at all.
No. Like, it's like kind of dawning on me that though it's a big difference from our normal life, I can totally live like this.
Yeah, I think so. I think this is pretty doable. Good morning.
Morning.
It's another morning after another night in the bus. It's fun sleeping in our fort.
And it's really comfortable.
And cozy and warm.
It's so quiet outside at night.
Yeah, maybe that's why I'm sleeping so good. You guys, usually I'm a terrible sleeper. I have really bad insomnia, but I've been sleeping good out here.
I did notice the wind came up last night. And it was really noticeable with that open.
Oh, really?
I heard this noise I'd never heard before. I was like, what is that noise?
And it was the wind blowing down.
It's the wind, yeah.
Oh, that's funny. I didn't even hear nothing. Okay, you ready for some coffee?
I'm so ready for coffee.
Let's do it.
Coffee is ready. Get some of that delicious nectar of the gods.
Sure is nice here, though.
I know.
We're going to spend a lot more time outside.
I know. I love it.
Except when it gets winter, then I'm going to spend a lot more time outside.
Well, in the winter times, it's still cold in the mornings, but the afternoons are still great here in the winter time. So
yeah,
we'll still be able to go on hikes and do stuff like that.
Right.
I'm so glad we get to stay here another day. I like this spot. Well, what say we get ready for that hike?
All right.
It's only getting hotter. We might as well get started now. Hi. Are you friendly? They are friendly. Hi, fellas. How are you doing? Hi. Oh my goodness, look at you. Whoa. It's like that one was trying to block this one from me. Hi, fella. Hi. Oh, you guys are good. You must be some rancher's horses out here. All right, fellas, see you later.
Where we were, like 300 feet, 400 feet, something like
there.
That. It's really not that high, but it was a cool vantage point.
It was a crazy vantage point.
Hey, we're almost 50. Give me a break, man. I'm not climbing Everest on my first trip. I'll
right?
be next week.
We climb Mount Neverest. See these little yellow flowers that grow by the side of the trail? They're as tiny as my pinky fingernail. Isn't that so cute? I love them. Time for an after hike ice pop.
That's right. Got these little idea, this little idea from Jessica, Painted Buffalo Traveling Studio, who is never short of little popsicles.
Yeah. Jessica, you got us hooked.
Mm-hmm.
This is like our junk food now. In our defense, it is Arizona and it's blistering hot every single day, so.
I know, to those of you watching the Pacific Northwest, we're not crazy. It's 90 something right now.
Oh yeah, this is my camp graffiti. It's how I leave my mark.
I titled it, First Sunset on the Margarita Deck.
Nice.
Best day ever.
Oh my God, I have to move over here tonight. Swing out of this. West.
Oh, this is my fire stick. This is my fire poker. I can't
burn
that.
Don't burn the fire poker, baby.
No way.
How come it doesn't say Carrie plus Mike? You just hurt my feelings.
I haven't finished that part yet.
Just hurt my feelings. Whoa, camera.
Whoa. Guess what time it is? Campfire time.
Second campfire in 2 days. Yes.
This is going to become a regular occurrence.
Right after sunset on the Margarita Deck. We didn't invite you to that one. Sorry, guys.
Yeah.
Some things are personal. We had to have that moment.
Sometimes you just do the thing without picking up the camera.
It has been an amazing day of hiking and seeing cool things and experiencing things and a lot of firsts. It's just been wonderful.
And then just hanging out in the bus and chilling and relaxing. Like,
took a little nappy poo.
Yeah, I took a nap. It seemed like the longest day. Like, we had so much time to do so many things.
Look, if you guys aren't on our Instagram, you should just, like, even if you're not on Instagram, go get on Instagram. I have so many photos to share. I'm going to be blowing up Instagram. I can't even help it. I love photography. That's, like, my thing.
You did it, baby. Another awesome fire.
Sorry. Thanks. I love making fires.
What?
I think it's my calling.
What?
I think I was meant to be an arsonist.
Jeez.
Right?
Some things should be left unsaid.
It's a good thing we have a wood-burning stove, so I have a place I can make fires.
Yeah.
I'm putting the shin killer on next.
Yeah. Have you shown him my injuries?
Have you shown him your injuries?
No.
That stick, Carrie just put a stick on the fire. It did that to me.
Yeah. See that thing on the fire? Let's see. See? Right here, this sticking up part, that's the part that got him. It's going to be burned before you know it.
I heard a noise. I got up to see what it was, and it stabbed me in the leg, and I killed it. You'll notice it's not nearly as long as it was.
Today's moving day. It's our last day at this campsite, so we're going to take advantage of it and go for one more hike before we have to leave.
It's hard to like want to leave a place like this to go to another place, but I guess that's the life of nomadic people, and we're those people, I guess.
Right, from one adventure to another.
I feel like we should put a Bussy new bus face sticker on here, but at the same time, I feel like it'd be like tagging.
Right? I like how these rocks make stair steps. Woo! I feel the burn.
Yeah, me too.
You guys, we have now seen 12 deer. 12 white-tailed deer that we've counted on this trail we've been on so far.
All right, you want to head back or head up?
Since it's moving day, I'm going to vote for heading back instead of continuing the adventure.
We're solid 2 miles in, I think.
Really? Wow.
I would think so. We're 31 floors. All right.
All right, let's do it back again.
Burn 1,254 calories.
Ta-da!
This is a pretty great place. I don't know, that might have been like a 4 miler.
I don't think it was that long. Oh, maybe 3 all the way.
Yeah.
There and back. Maybe so.
Don't show them this. Super secret.
Let's see how Mama Kitty is doing. Oh, Mama, what's up? What were you doing in the house while the people were gone? Holding down the bed? Good job, Mamacita. Good job.
I hope you guys enjoyed our first day, our first camp spot, I guess.
Yeah, it's time for us to leave the first spot we ever stayed at in the bus. And Mike has to go to work for 3 times over the next 5-day period, and he doesn't want to leave me out here in the bus alone while I don't really understand like the whole solar system and stuff like that. So we're just gonna go and park at his work for the next 5 days, and then we'll be headed off on another adventure again after that. So
that's right,
we'll pick you up then for sure.
All right, see you guys later.
Take care, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Don't forget to subscribe.